busy doing things around the house so I wouldn't think about what would happen later. I could never even remember it afterwards.
You're really sweating about this, aren't you?
Yeah.
Look, even if things are rocky with the kids, it can't be the same as it was with you and your old man.
Rita, I'm almost sure. I just have to get him to admit it.
Oh, Nance. Maybe it'll turn out that you're wrong.
Dear God, I just don't know what I'm going to do if it's true.
Well, there's no point in upsetting yourself, like. If it's upsetting you this much, you should just let them sort it out themselves.
No, no, I've been through it, and I know I can help them. The hard part is just me facing up to it, but if I don't do it now, then it'll just get harder. Don't you worry about me. I'll be all right.
Okay. Is there anything I can do?
Well, you could help me straighten up this mess.
Yeah, nice wit. I reckon Merle, he'll give us a hand too, eh?
Oh, yeah.
Well, we should have it done in 2 seconds flat then.
Delia? Mrs. Morris, I heard about Marty. Are you all right?
Mm-hmm. Just. Apparently, Dan Moulton, who's a friend of Anne's, is directing operations. She's going to find out what he knows.
He shouldn't be there. He was so frightened.
You know?
Oh, we're friends. We confide in each other, you know, sort of brother and sister thing.
Obviously care about him to be this upset.
So not knowing that's so frightening.
I know. I think if I don't hear soon, I'll go crazy.
Nancy McCormick's son is in reception. Dina, if you're not doing anything, would you take him through, please? Otherwise, I'll never get my coffee break.
Joyce?
Yes? Oh. Oh, I'm sorry. I just wasn't thinking. Look, don't you two worry about it. I'll see to it.
I'll do it.
No, you've got too much on your mind.
No, give me something to do. And besides, I am sort of involved. You stay with Delia for a while?
Yes, of course.
I'm all right now.
Bloody hell, Nance, when you're clean, you're really clean. How did you move all this stuff by yourself?
Oh, I honestly can't remember.
It's not heavy. Well, for you, maybe. You going to come and have some lunch?
Oh, no, no, I couldn't eat anything.
You must be hungry. Come on, otherwise I'll worry about you.
Oh, all right, I suppose I should eat something.
Yeah. Well, that's pretty much it. Let's go.
McCall, your son's here to see you.
Oh.
Go on, Nance. It'll be okay.
Right.
Hey, Mrs. Morris, any word on Mr. Jackson yet?
No, not yet.
Well, I reckon he's okay. He's got a head on his shoulders, that boy.
I forgot something. I gotta go back.
You sure this is where she was gonna chuck it?
Yeah, it's supposed to be here somewhere.
Well, it's not. Don't get shooty with me. All I know is it's supposed to be here.
Well, the screws must have found it.
Yeah, I would have found out if they did.
Oh, jeez, we've looked everywhere.
Yeah. All right, let's go back in, huh?
Oh, back in? No way. Look, you can do what you bloody well like, but I'm buggered.
Didn't get much sleep last night, remember?
Yeah, well, I didn't exactly sleep like a log either, you know. And I went to a lot of trouble to get on garbage details so I could come out here and collect me presents. And I'm not going back in till I do.
Oh, diddums. Look, Jess must have slipped up somehow. I'll give her a call and see what happened. But if I don't get back in, Mrs. Pringle's going to be out here looking for me. Only let me out for a breath of fresh air.
Oh, jeez, Lex, I'm busting to know what it is. Come on, tell me.
No bloody way. Jess would kill me if I spoilt the surprise.
Yeah, well, I'm gonna kill you if you don't.
No,
Come on, tell me,
you're just gonna have to wait and find out. Anyway, wouldn't believe me if I told you.
Hello? My name's Merle.
What's yours?
Hi, Mum. Afraid I can only stay a few minutes.
No, that's all right, Peter. Sit down.
So, what's this about the house that's so urgent?
Peter, how's Danielle?
Oh, she's fine. She said someone from here called in at the house this morning.
I never worried about you. It was always Harry. He was so much like your father, I was certain he'd turn out the same way.
I'm not sure I follow you, Miss.
You can't even look me in the eye, can you?
What?
You look me in the eye, and you tell me again that Danielle is fine.
Well, she is. What's this all about?
Oh,
Peter, you know what it's about. Did you honestly think you could hide it from me? My God, if it had been anyone but the two of you, I would have noticed the first time I saw the two of you together.
Look, I don't have a clue what you're talking
about. You are beating her.
What?
If anybody should know the signs, I should. All that nervous talking she does forever to looking to you to make sure she said the right thing, and now bruises from so-called accidents.
Oh, come on, Mum. You know better than anyone how much I hated what Dad did to you. Besides, I love Danielle.
Well, your father loved me in his way. Are you drinking? Is that what makes
you're
do
wrong.
It? You're wrong. No. Pray God, I pray to God I would be. I just wish I could understand, that's all.
Look, whatever Danielle's told you, it's not true. It's my fault. Well, I should have been more specific when I said there were things wrong. The thing is, she's a compulsive fantasizer. I didn't realize till I married her, but she lives in a world of her own. Every time I try to get through to her, to help her, she sees it as an intrusion. And in her mind, she translates it as a physical attack.
Are you telling me that she makes it all up?
Yes. Yes, but she's getting better, Mum. She really is. With a little more time, I think I can get through to her. Well, the only alternative is for her to see a psych. That'll make everything seem worse than it is.
I see. Well, now, of course, I know the point of all that education.
What do you mean?
You've learned to tell a much better class of lie than your father could. He'd be impressed.
I'm not lying. But what would you know about it anyway? You're in one kind of trouble after another. You're locked away in here. You got the nerve to criticize me. I didn't ask you to kill Dad. It's not my fault you're here.
But Peter, would you stop talking about your father? It's you and Danielle I'm worried about.
Well, don't be. Just don't be. She's my wife. I don't need your advice on how to handle her. If you don't want to believe me, that's up to you.
Yes, it is.
You haven't got a clue what I put up with. She's got no will of her own. She's like some kind of whimpering dog if I try to criticize her. What the hell else am I supposed to do? Well, tell me, what am I supposed to do? Now, I didn't mean that. You misunderstood me.
Stop it, Peter. Stop it. We both know you did.
You think you know everything, don't you? Well, you're wrong. What you think doesn't matter anyway, because in my own house, I'm going to do what I want.
If you knew how often I heard your father say that.
I'm sick of hearing about my father. I'm sick of this whole conversation. I'm sick of you. I'm sorry. I'm sorry, Mum. I never meant for it to happen. It just did. But it'll never happen again, I swear.
No, it's all right, Peter. It's all right. At least now it's out in the open. I don't suppose it really is your fault.
No, it isn't, Mum. If you knew Danny better...
No, I didn't mean that. I meant growing up in the house with your father.
I know you're disappointed. I'm sorry.
Well, I'm not the one you should be saying that to.
Yeah, well, I'll talk to Danielle. We'll sort things out.
No. I think it's going to need more than that.
What do you mean?
You need to see someone to get help.
Oh, come on, Mum. It's not as bad as that.
How can you say that? You should be glad there are people who can help you. There was nobody around when your father and I were young.
Yeah, but that was different.
It was not different at all, Peter. It always starts out the same. Now you must see somebody before it's too late.
Yeah, okay, Mum. Whatever you want.
Good. And I want to speak to Danielle because she needs somebody who understands.